Okay, so my. Oh, there we go, button didn't work. We find ourselves back on the Korean server, boys and girls. It is still a best of nine. Nothing has changed in that regard. In the top right, you can see Team Liquid currently leads 3-0 at the moment. That's pretty rough. But finally, after what feels like an eternity, we have Stardust stepping back into the fray. I don't know what's been going on. He's not been available in the last couple of Acer Team Strike Cup matches. Again, worth noting, Stardust and Jakshi are at home in Korea, currently on vacation from the team house. And Penguin tells me they'll be back soon, but they've been a little bit hard to get a hold of, and I wonder if time conflicts, scheduling, etc., if these have been things that have just been, I guess, hard to do. Whatever the case may be, I'm glad to see him finally step into the match. He's spawning here in the bottom left corner, ladies and gentlemen. It is Stardust. In the top right, playing for Team Liquid. He's off to a pretty good start. He's gotten three kills under his belt so far. It is a Liquid Hero. All right, so for this matchup, Stardust PvP has come a long way. Heroes PvP, I think, has never really been his best, and quite frankly, I don't ever think it will be. But that being said, Heroes PvP. Well, first off, he's playing against Stardust, and he knows this, so he checks for proxy right away. Stardust is known for his cheesy antics, I think we can call it safely. But yeah, his PvP is not bad, but it's never really been his shining point, I feel. Whereas Stardust has kind of turned that around. Once upon a time, Stardust PvP was the worst. You'd watch Stardust, and you'd be like, yeah, okay, this game is over. Like, you know, it's PvP, he's gonna lose. But now I can say it's safely probably one of his better matchups. I don't know if that's statistically true or not, but I'm just speaking completely off of context of having games we've cast him in. Ooh, I actually have 2-2 on gas, not the full 3-3. Hero, of course, only taking one gas at the moment himself. We'll see if he wants to go for that expand or not. Expanding early on in Protoss, though, risky business, and he will take that second gas instead, so never mind. Back at home, though, CyberCore on the way. Due time. Stardust can go off of that probe scout. It's such a nuisance in PvP. A lot of what you want to do as a Protoss player is, of course, hide your tech. You don't want them to see you go for the Twilight Council. You don't want them to know you're rushing out of Stargate. But unfortunately, due to the way timing permits, as we see both probes pass each other in the middle of the map, you can kind of get this free scout. And because Mothership cores are delayed, because Stalkers take a little bit longer to get out, and Zealots are too slow to catch probes, you can just play a ring around the rosy and actually scout all day with a probe. It's quite annoying as a player who wants to hide tech. Stardust actually, oh my god, almost loses his probe. Other side of the map, it's not quite as close. Trying to keep an eye on which dies first here, the red or the blue. Loving you. Okay, well, the Stalker coming out will finally clean this up, not to mention the Mothership core here as well. And the probe can no longer escape, so I think Stardust is going to be the one who dies. Who gets slaughtered? Exclamation mark blood. Well, actually, probes don't bleed. They're robots. So, like, I guess it's a little anticlimactic. In fact, I don't know if anything actually bleeds from Protoss. Because Stalkers kind of erupt into, like, blue goo slash explosions. Zealots just catch on fire and dissipate into nothingness. Immortals were already dead once, right? That's why they came back again. Ooh, bit of an awkward misclick out of Stardust. But a Stargate is going to be his choice here. Now, Stargate's not a bad opener by any means. Again, Phoenixes have a lot of weird potential. Oracles can sometimes auto-win you games. Stalker is going to try and kite around the Mothership core a little bit for damage, but realizing he might need it at home, decides to walk it on in. Now, as far as the unit counting station goes at the moment, Stardust can actually win this fight pretty one-sidedly, actually. Mothership core is sent packing, and for now, Hero, well, he's kind of, I feel, faking this. I mean, he's got extra gateways on the way, but they're not already done is the problem. Gets to the main and scouts the Stargate of his opponent. Phoenix Wars, oh my god. Okay, so in StarCraft 2, it's come a long way in Heart of the Swarm. We have seen Mutalisk versus Mutalisk at this point. I'm hoping at some point one of you players says, or one of you viewers says as well, that no one's been sort of deprived of that privilege. Now that being said, we've seen how abruptly Mutalisk versus Mutalisk Wars can end games. You're like, shut up, Rifkin, it's Protoss versus Protoss. My point is, Phoenixes have that same sort of anticlimactic solution towards the end. Where, because technically Stardust will always be up one over his opponent. Well, actually, hang on, is he going to cancel this? No, he's just going to go full on with it. Because Stardust will always give up like at least one Phoenix or two to his opponent. Okay, there's the cancel. I was going to say, it doesn't make sense for him to complete this. But instead, he hides the Twilight Council down here to the lower right. Ooh. But cancels that too! And instead starts it at home. Okay, so this is some weird stuff going on. Oh, he scouted it. Ooh. Okay, so this is weird out of Hero, and this is kind of subtle. What's happening right now is he's warping a lot of Stalkers. He wants to make it look like he's trying to protect his position. Because maybe he thinks Stardust didn't really see it. Or, you know, it's that mind gaming that I know what she said. Or she thinks that I know, but he thinks that, you know, that sort of BS. But as he gets chased back here, Stardust is going to find that Twilight Council was canceled. Now, in his vision as well, as he picks up these last couple Stalkers, it's worth noting that he still thinks there's a Stargate coming out of Liquid Hero. So while this is happening, well, actually, no, he saw the Stargate canceled, but he didn't see the Twilight Council remade. So Stargate's been, all right, revealed. The jig's up in that regard, but Hero's actually going to win the Stalker fight. Blink is going to be really nice to have, too. And quite frankly, this is actually looking really good for Hero. I was about to start talking about how he had, like, mind game Stardust, but to no avail. Because, you know, what good is placing this down and faking it out if you just rebuild it at home? If Stardust still thought a Stargate was coming in, this would actually be really good. But he doesn't. He saw the Council at home. He knows the Twilight Council isn't there in the bottom right. But does he have enough units to actually fight with? He's got a couple Phoenix in the air. But again, it's not going to be Phoenix Wars by any means. The Graviton Beams will help out a little bit as he kind of crowd controls his opponent. Yeah, this will allow him to pick up a couple of Stalkers here for free, but he's got to be careful because there's still Zealots to buff on the ground, and Zealots, not only the tanky, as we see, if they can connect, they do some real good damage. Meanwhile, another Phoenix does get sniped off, and as far as unit counting station goes, guys, it is 8 Stalkers to 6. The difference is Stardust, again, he can Graviton Beam up 2 of these. You can kind of crowd control them out of the fight, out of the game. If you get across the map and do a little bit of counterattack, that'd be really nice too. But one of the big things Stardust has leading for him is his natural base is already finished. He's mining off of this. And this is why he's been at a bit of a deficit when it comes to the army value. Alright, looks like he finally cleans up Hero's presence. Hero's going to clean up this one pylon over here. Both players going to suffer a bit of supply issue, albeit momentarily. Someone's saying it shouldn't have been First Blood, it should have been First Probe! Yo, if I knew the guy who did the announcer voices, would totally go get like a custom clip made. And as you see, again, that crowd control feature coming out of the Graviton Beam, it's a really nice, really handy-dandy thing to have. Unfortunately, the Phoenix is, again, flying a little bit too close to the sun, so to speak, as he loses one or two throughout the course of this game, and really, I feel with perfect control would obviously lose none. However, this is looking pretty darn good for Stardust as he gets aggressive on the other side of the map, picks off those sentries. His Stalker count is superior to that of Hero's, and let's not forget, this Nexus is not down. The Mothership Core does not exist, and when it comes out, the Phoenixes may very well finish it off. Trying to focus this down a little bit, doesn't quite have enough to DPS it. Hero does have Blink over top of Stardust, and that Time Warp's going to be quite nasty to deal with. And as we see Blink starting to push back, is this going to be enough though? Will the micro and the control outweigh sheer raw damage and power and numbers? It looks like it might just do so. A lot of these Stalkers are really low, but a lot of the Stalkers are living to see another day, and Stardust is going to lose a lot of Stalkers here. Now it's worth noting the probe count is somewhat similar, but because he's been mining off of his other base, he's mining a little more efficiently is the thing. I don't know if he can necessarily make up an 11-3 deficit, especially with no Photon Overcharge, but he's got to try, because Hero is going to possibly end the game if Stardust isn't careful. As he marches on across the map, he quickly dispatches with the pylon. He still has Blink. This is something that hasn't changed. These Stalkers are just going to Blink forward on top of the three Stardust has, and I think, ladies and gentlemen, this is looking pretty bad for Stardust. GG is called, and Hero, oh my god, Hero, one game away from the all-kill now! Is in a really good spot for Team Liquid. Alright, let's go ahead and change that to a 4. Because I will forget.